sa pagtustos ng inyong pag-aaral ng inyong mga magulang. Ang lahat po ng ito ay magagana kung mangyayari kung tayo po ay mayroong pagtitiis. Doon po sa pagputol ng napakalaking punong kahoy, nung hindi pa uso yung ating mga electronics na mga gamit, mga mechanical na mga gamit, gumagamit po yung mga tao sa pagputol ng troso nung isang malaking lagari na ang humahawak po nito ay dalawang tao. Pagkabila po yun, no? Push and pull, no? Merong putulang at merong hahata. So dalawa po yun ang kailangan gawin ng magkaibang tao para ma-achieve nila yung tinatawag na pagputol sa isang troso. At ito po ay isang bagay na inyong gagalapin, kapungkulan ng mga magulang, kapungkulan ng inyong mga anak para sa isang isa. Hindi po mangyayari na maganap ng inyong mga anak na makapuntong sa masusunod na antas ng kanilang pagtatapos kung wala pong pagtulong kayong mga magulang at ganunin din kayong mga bata. Hawak ninyo yung hawakan sa pagkabilang tulong. Parehas kayong gagawa. Hindi pwedeng isa lang yung naglalagari, no? Para mas mabilis, sabi nga natin kanina, ano ba ang bunga ng pagkakaisa natin? Siyempre, mas magiging mabilis. Kung isa lang yung gagawa nito, at magiging sabilitan pa, no? Mas matagal yung tinatawag ng proseso. Kinakailangan po natin na ipakita yung ating pagkakaisa. Pausapin natin ang ating mga anak sa mga bagay na gusto nilang mangyari sa kanilang buhay. At kayo mga anak, mga magsisipagtako sa taong ito, pwede rin naman kayong lumapit sa inyong mga magulang para sabihin ang inyong nais para sa inyong buhay. Ano ba ang gusto ninyong marating? Nasa pagkakaisa ng mga magulang at ng mga bata ang kakatutumpay ng mga bata ito. Muli, mga magulang, mga sisipagtapos na mga bata sa taong ito, ginabati ko po kayo at nawa ay magtagumpay kayo sa anumang at higain na inyong nianais para sa kaprihan ng ating Panginoon at para sa katagumpay ng inyong pamilya. Magandang bago po sa inyo lang.
Sir, we request you to please stand up for the giving of our certificate of recognition, together with our school directress, Ernesto C. Francisco, our chairman of the board, Mr. Ernesto C. Francisco, and our math and science coordinator, Sir Amir Hanan.
Emmaus Christian Schools of Barbarian, in sincere recognition and gratitude for victorious service, full support and inspiring presence as guest speaker in our commencement exercises 2012 Pageant in the Metric Department held at the Emmaus Foundation Garden, Coloocto, Venezuela City. Given this 31st day of March in the year of our Lord, 2012 in Venezuela City. Signed by our Chairman of the Board, Ernesto R. Francisco, and the School Directress, Ernesto C. Francisco, giving this certificate of recognition to Mr. Jose G. S. Escobar.
at school, especially my teacher Lola and teacher Clarissa, to Mr. and Mrs. Francisco, and to all our respected visitors today. A pleasant good morning to all of you. To our parents, we would like to thank you for taking care of us 24/7. Thank you for the hardship and effort, for giving your best to survive everything we need and sometimes want to. Thank you also for your guidance, sacrifices, patience as well, to discipline and teach us and support us to improve more our talent and knowledge. We appreciate your unconditional love for us. Deep inside in our heart, we love you very much. We are very grateful for what you are doing and that for us as your children. For our teachers, teacher Lola and teacher Clarissa, thank you for the quality time to teach us with patience so that we will understand our lesson. We will miss you, teacher. We hope that we will see you again next school year. And finally, to our Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for your kindness, for having a family that we belong. Thank you also for giving us wisdom to know what is right and what is wrong. Thank you for giving us a different talent that we will use it to please you and to our loved ones. We ask for your guidance and continue to bless us as we go along to finish our studies. Again, to my classmates and to all the graduates and parents as well, congratulations and good day to each every one of us. I thank you.
And now, let's hear it from the Graces Valedictorian, Beatrice Yuna M. Oriane.
Patient teachers, to our ever-loving and hard-working school directress, Mrs. Arlena Francisco, to my classmates and fellow graduates, and to their parents. Ladies and gentlemen, good day. The Holy Bible quotes in the book of Psalm 118, verse 24, "This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Truly, this is the day that the Lord Jesus Christ has given us to celebrate, rejoice, and be glad. Each day is a blessing, but the day is a day of rejoicing, because we students have been given a present or a gift, the gift of knowledge, the gift that we will treasure for the rest of our life, the gift that no one can steal from us, the gift of knowledge that will be our key to achieve our goals, our dreams, and our ideal near perfect life. Having this gift will truly change our simple life, and ignorance will be overshadowed by wisdom. I was once a baby, a child given birth and nourished by my ever-caring and loving parents. Childhood ignorance was still present in me. But at the age of 2, my parents started teaching me ABCs and 1, 2, 3, red, white, and blue for colors, and squares and circles for shapes. But look at me now, I have attained the highest recognition that every student strives to finish, and every parent likes their child to accomplish. But please, with all due respect, let me remind each and every one that being this particular award was never easy. I exerted so much effort in being proficient in English, eloquent in reciting lessons, profound in mathematics, brilliant in science, splendid in social studies, and most of all, full of passion in my education. And to top it all, everything was a family effort. I was blessed to be with a very supportive family, a family that is God-fearing, full of love, full of dreams and aspirations. He supported me all the way, so I want to share this honor and achievement to all of them. To my mommy Ophelia for being so kind and understanding, Lola. To my titos and titas who are always there to help me on my assignments, projects, and in my extracurricular activities. To my cousins who also give me points in my studies. To my kuya Renzo, who oversees me when I'm in school. To my papa, who works hard and sacrifices the work of God to him to be able to support and provide for us. I love you so much. I recognize the time that we spend together reviewing and studying. I know that we will be together one day, and I am looking forward to it. To my mama, who loves me unconditionally, who takes care of me when I am sick, who was my very first teacher, who never fails to work, to wake up in every morning to prepare breakfast and school lunch, to check my assignments, and to fix my hair. My mama painstakingly trained and tutored me when examinations were approaching. And for all of that, I love you so much and I thank you. All of them, my whole family, made this possible and I want to thank them all. Also, I would like to thank the Emmaus Christian School family, to the principal, and to her loyal staff, to our smart and industrious teachers, and especially to my advisor, Sertis Serrano. Thank you for your mentorship and for your guidance. Also, I would like to acknowledge each and every parent of all the amazing students. You made this possible. Without your efforts, love, and provision, your love, your child would not be here accepting their diplomas and achievements. All of you made it easy for us to reach our dreams and pursue a new chapter of our life. To all my classmates, my fellow graduates, especially to my friends, thank you for raising and facing the challenges with me. We always think that this graduation of art, this momentous event, is the culmination of attaining education and wisdom. But it is not. It is just the beginning of obtaining more knowledge, facing more challenges, doing more new activities, experiments, and lessons to gain. So I encourage you all to let us all be courageous and be fearless in facing knowledge and wisdom. Let us move forward to the higher level of education. Let us all promise to ourselves, our parents, and families that we cannot be stopped by challenges, by obstacles, and by trials. Because we have Jesus, who has the greatest teacher of life in our hearts. But we will not